This UCSD TV program is presented by University of California Television. Like what you learn? Visit our website or follow us on Facebook and Twitter to keep up with the latest programs.
We are the paradoxical ape. Bipedal, naked, large-brained, long the master of fire, tools, and language, but still trying to understand ourselves. Aware that death is inevitable, yet filled with optimism. We grow up slowly. We hand down knowledge. We empathize and deceive. We shape the future from our shared understanding of the past. Carta brings together experts from diverse disciplines to exchange insights on who we are and how we got here. An exploration made possible by the generosity of humans like you.
Welcome. We begin another extremely interesting session with some very promising speakers in front of me. I'm Margaret Schoeninger. I am co-director, one of the co-directors of CARTA, and I just, again, want to say welcome. For CARTA, as the video was portraying, we're very interested in the oldest questions of humans. So what we're looking at is, who are we? What are we doing here? We all are interested in this. Where did we come from? How did we get here? Where are we going? But there are only really two questions of that list that we can begin to really address scientifically, really collect data on them. So that's why CARTA was formed. CARTA is anthropogeny, and it is trying to explain the origin of humans. It's from an old dictionary saying, and Oxford Dictionary in 2006 actually put it together, came from 1839. And so we do anything we can to try to understand the origin of humans. We are a rather large group at this point. We started very small, but we are a pretty large group now, with three co-directors, one of whom is in front of me, Professor Ajit Varkey. Rusty Gage was unable to join us. I see the associate director here, Pascal Gagnon, who actually was the voiceover in the previous video. We have an management services officer you are going to see walking around the room a lot, Linda Nelson. Community relations director I saw walking all around, Ingrid, and she's still working, Ingrid Vernishka Perkins. We have a computer programmer analyst who's taken care of all the live streaming. That is Kate Kaya. Program director Jesse Roby. And administrative assistant, Steffi Petty. I think you would get this from the video, but just in case you didn't, we are pulling together experts from multiple fields all over. We add as we find an interesting target. So we have people from physical and chemical sciences, biomedical sciences, social sciences, all across campus. We have a mission statement that we will use all rational and ethical approaches to seek verifiable facts from all relevant disciplines to explore and explain the origins of the human phenomenon. We try to minimize complex organizational structure and hierarchies, but as I was talking to someone at lunch, as we've gotten larger and larger, that is becoming more and more difficult. We try to avoid unnecessary paperwork and bureaucracy, but it's very difficult to do with a large organization as we are now. In the process, we really are trying to raise awareness and understanding of the study of human origins within the academic and also the public at large, which is why we do these large public presentations. In order to do that, we have one exceptionally wonderful sponsor. It is the G. Harold and Lila Mathers Charitable Foundation of New York, with Jim Handelman, who is the executive director, who often comes but is not here today. This is going to be video recorded with closed captioning due to the generosity of Rita Atkinson, Liz Lancaster, Eli Scheffer, and also Sue Rosner. And I want to thank especially Annette Merle-Smith, because there are some young people here, and they are here because of her generosity in providing support for some of our fellows within our anthropogeny specialization track. So thank you, Annette. We have, yes, thank you, Annette. We have a number of individual sponsors, and we are grateful to each one of them. I also want to thank UCSD-TV for the video recording and some of the closed captioning, and Sauk Media Services. We wouldn't be here if it weren't for the Sauk Media people. So, in order to begin, I am going to turn this over to our co-chair, Steve Churchill, from Duke University, and let him begin. Thank you, Steve.